I'm living for later, living for later.
Don't hit the panic button. We are living in a time where it's almost every week you're hearing about some shooting and just people losing their lives just left and right, and it all just seems so senseless, and it's easy for us to get into a panic because it seems as if the drama is just building and building and building. But as saints of God, we shouldn't hit the panic button, right? I love how in Isaiah 8, verses 11 and 14a says, "The Lord has given me a strong warning not to think like everyone else does." This is the prophet Isaiah speaking. So this is what the Lord says to him. He said, "Don't call everything a conspiracy like they do, and don't live in dread of what frightens them. Make the Lord of heaven's armies holy in your life. He is the one you should fear. He is the one who should make you tremble. He will keep you safe." So again, we just think about all that's going on, and this is such an opportunity for us as the children of God, for our lights to shine. This is not a time for us to start panicking and then hiding our lights or causing our salt to lose its flavor. People are looking for an answer, and that answer is Jesus. I don't have to be fearful of what's going on around me. The only person that I have to fear is God. That's it. This is what the scripture is saying, because at the time that this was written, Judah, they were coming against some strong attacks, and God speaks to Isaiah, and he's telling them, you don't have to be fearful of all that's going on around you. And that same message is true for us today. I don't have to be fearful of what's going on around me. And I think of Psalms 27 that says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" Right? And it goes on to talk about, when evil people come to attack me, they will stumble and fall. Even if I am attacked, I will remain confident, right? Because I know in whom I serve. I know in whom I put my trust. So I want to encourage you again to not hit the panic button. If people are engaging you in conversation about all the craziness that's going on in the world, pray and ask the Lord to fill you with the boldness to speak up and share with them why you are not fearful, why you can have peace in the midst of this storm, why you can be confident that even if your life is snuffed out by some crazy killer, God forbid, that you're not afraid of that, because you know in whom you put your trust, and you know that if this is your last breath, if today is your last day, you know where you're going. Come on, saints of God. This is such an opportunity for us to let our lights shine. Don't jump on the fear bandwagon. Don't panic. Open up your mouth and declare to the people that they don't have to be fearful either if they put their trust in God. And by no means am I trying to sound insensitive to those that have lost their lives. Absolutely not. It's a hard thing when you watch these things, and it can weigh so heavily on your spirit if you don't really bring it to the Lord in prayer and really just ask him to, again, give you the boldness to minister when you have the opportunities. So I just want to conclude there and just encourage you to say, you know what? Don't be fearful. Don't hit the panic button. Speak out when you have the opportunity. And my heart goes out to those who have lost during this time with all these senseless killings. As the Church of Christ, we should be praying for these individuals. And, just in all of this, I just pray that God will redeem in some way, because he certainly is a redeemer. And I pray that even through all of this hurt and all this pain, that many will come to know the Lord as a result of this. All right, you be blessed.